now leaving the count on Niehaus. Niehaus with a two-run home run yesterday in the top of the eighth inning. Put the Colonels up 2-1 at the time. Huskies had led 1-0 until that home run. Huskies tied it in the bottom half of the eighth, went into extra innings. Colonels scored three runs in the top of the 11th. Huskies answered with two, but couldn't get that tying run home. The throw over to first. So we'll wrap up this series today here with this doubleheader. No game tomorrow. The 1-1 from Batten. It's fouled off. Brady's last start came against the University of Houston on March 6th. Huskies with a 3-1 victory over the Cougars. Batten getting the win in that game. Went seven innings, gave up the one run on three hits, struck out seven, and walked two. 1-2 pitch. Niehaus with a ground ball to short. DePreta Johnson flips it to Riley for one. Over to first for the double play. That retires a side in the first inning. We go to the bottom half. Nicholls nothing. HBU coming to bat here on the Husky Sports Network.
How can I help you?
Have you ever walked into the paint store feeling like you should really know more than you know? Satin versus semi-gloss and I don't know.
Yes, I know the feeling.
That's how I feel right now about all of the financing options for this project I'm doing. I feel like I should know more than I know.
Don't sweat it. We have this new tool, My Credit Options Guide. It gives you a customized comparison like this, which helps you discover which credit options might be right for you.
Oh, this is better. They should make one for paint.
Want to get started?
Sure.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
Russ Renault back here at Husky Field. Huskies coming up to bat here in the bottom of the first inning of Game 2 in this doubleheader. Turned out to be a pretty nice day here on this Saturday. Pretty gloomy and overcast this morning. But the sun trying to peek out a little bit here in the afternoon. It's 80 degrees at game time. Wind out of the south-southeast. About 7 miles per hour, so it's blowing gently out to left. Huskies hit three home runs in the first game of this doubleheader. Spencer Halloran, opposite field solo blast. Tyler DePreta Johnson with a two-run shot, and then Halloran a three-run shot late in the game. So here's Jonathan Dukoff to lead it off. Jonathan, junior center fielder from Kingwood, Kingwood Park High School. Now drive into center field. That sends Niehaus back. Just shy of the track in dead center. Makes the catch for the first out. Dukoff came into the game hitting .293. Four doubles, a home run, two RBIs, and nine runs scored. Now to bring up Derek Riley. Junior second baseman from Anaheim, California, El Dorado High School, Santa Ana College. Derek with his first extra base hit as a Husky in game one. Now hitting .214. Three RBIs, five runs scored. Takes a strike here from Hatcher. Caden Hatcher, right-hander, 6'5", 200 pounds, a senior from Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida. South Georgia Community College, and Riley takes a strike behind in the count 0-2. Hatcher making his 10th appearance, third start, 0-1 with a 3.47 ERA. The 0-2 pitch, that's taken outside for a ball. Hatcher's allowed 12 runs, 9 of them earned, 30 hits, 23 strikeouts, only one walk in 23 and a third innings. So he's going to be in the strike zone. The 1-2 is low and away. The count evens up on Riley. Two-two pitch. And Riley takes it low and away for a full count. Payoff pitch on the way. Riley foul ball out of play on the left side. One out, nobody on. Another 3-2 to Riley. There's a drive into center field. Sends Niehaus back. He has room. Makes the catch for the second out.
Left fielder number 14, Spencer Halloran.
Here's Spencer Halloran, senior left fielder from Sheffield, Iowa. Takes a ball outside. Spencer hitting .299, four doubles, three home runs, 10 RBIs, 12 runs scored. Ground ball to short, backhanded by Morales. The throw to first, pulls the first baseman off the bag, but he just is able to get back on for the out. We go to the second inning. No score between HBU and Nicholls here on the Husky Sports Network.
We all have special moments in life. Moments that we will remember forever. Best friends become family. At River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, we love family. You are a part of the River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram family. Live your best moments of life in a Jeep from River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram.
Don't you worry, my child. Everything's going to be just fine. Little darling, you keep on walking in, 'cause I ain't never going to leave your side.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe, so you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
Top of the second inning here at Husky Field. Mikhail Noth to lead it off for Nicholls. Be followed by Gage Tier and Dane Simon.
Leading off for the Colonels, the catcher, number 18, Kyle Noth.
Noth, the senior catcher from Mandeville, Louisiana. Went 1-for-4 and drove in a run in game one. Puts him at .240 for the year with 5 doubles, a triple, 2 home runs, 11 RBIs, 14 runs scored. Foul ball in on the hands, 1-1. Pop popped up on the left side. Simone's going to chase it, but runs out of room. 1-2 on Noth. Leadoff batter here in the second for the Colonels. Batting with the pitch. Just misses inside. It's 2-2. And back-to-back left-handers at the 3 and 4 spots for Nicholls. And then the last three batters are lefties. Noth with a drive into right field. Heck on the run. It's going to skip and bounce off the wall. Noth is into second with a stand-up double. Noth ties Brady Bell for the team lead with six doubles now for the Colonels.
First baseman number 10, Gage Tier.
Now here's Gage Tier. Senior first baseman from Brandon, Mississippi. Went 2-for-4 in game one, drove it, scored a run, had a double. His fifth of the year. He has 10 RBIs and 11 runs scored this season. Kerry Jones at first base anticipating a bunt. Deer takes a strike on the outside corner. Batten had Noth leaning the other way towards third, but nobody was covering second base. The 0-1 pitch in the dirt, blocked by Pulshan, the catcher. Batten deals. That pitch is down. So 2-1 count on Tier. Nobody out in the runner at second for Nicholls. Batten misses low. It's 3-1. Batten deals. That's in there for a strike. Two pitch just misses low and outside. So Tier walks, runners at first and second for Dane Simon. Freshman right fielder from Destrehan, Louisiana. Simon 1-for-3 with an RBI. In game one, hitting 205, a double, a home run, 10 RBIs, 8 runs scored. Squares around to bunt. Pulls the bat back, takes the ball outside. Squares around again, pulls it back, and takes another ball. 2-0 now to Simon. Pops it up. He's going to get it down, though. Simone skips it past the first. Riley covering over at first base. One run is going to come in. So it's a sacrifice for Simon and an error on Simone.
Fielder number 4, Lee Clark.
So here's Lee Clark. Still nobody out. Runners at second and third now for the Colonels. Tier able to go to third. Simon goes to second. There's a strike to Clark. The 0-1 pitch from Batten, down and in for ball one. Batten takes a long look in, so Clark steps out. Clark, senior left fielder from Tuscaloosa, Alabama. And a drive foul on the right side. Clark went 0 for 4 in the first game. Now hitting 213. 5 doubles, 2 home runs. Still leads the Colonels with 15 RBIs and has scored 10 times. To 1-2 count. Nobody out, runners at second and third. Nicholls with a 1-0 lead over HBU here in the second inning, game 2 of this doubleheader. Batten with the pitch, popped up to Riley at second, and will make the catch for the first out.
Designated hitter number 17, Landon Powell.
I'm bringing up Landon Powell, left-handed batter. Junior getting the start at designated hitter today. He's from Mobile, Alabama. Did not see Powell in game one. He's hitting 207, 2 doubles, no RBIs, 4 runs scored. Drives this one the other way. Halloran on the run. He'll make the catch. A run comes home. The Colonels lead it 2-0.
Third baseman number 12, Brady Bell.
So both of the runs Batten has allowed this inning are unearned. Pitch down and in to Brady Bell, senior third baseman from Panama City, Florida. Bell went 0 for 2 in game 1. 1-0 pitch, swing and a foul back. Bell hitting 320, six doubles, seven RBIs, six runs scored. One and one count with two down, runner at second. Ground ball to short. DePreta Johnson charges it, flips to first for the third out. We go to the bottom of the second inning. Nicholls 2, HBU nothing, here on the Husky Sports Network.
That moment you realized he really does love you. That moment your boss thanked you for crushing it like a boss in the sales meeting. That moment you decided to treat you. Whatever that moment is, Tiff's Treats warm cookies, baked from scratch and delivered warm, are the perfect companion. Tiff's Treats. Order now at cookiedelivery.com.
The Southland Conference.
4,200 student athletes
from across the country
and around the world.
Representing 13 member institutions
from Arkansas, Texas, and Louisiana.
Excelling in 17 NCAA Division I sports.
In the classroom.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Back here at Husky Field, Huskies trailing 2-0 to the Colonels. Two unearned runs for Nicholls in the top of this inning. It'll be Jake Fulshon to lead it off for HBU, senior catcher from Menifee, California. Jake 1-for-4 in the first game, sitting 214 with a double, 14 RBIs to lead HBU, and he scored twice. First pitch from Hatcher, a fastball in there for a strike. Slider for a strike on the outside corner. That slider misses low, 1-2. One-two pitch. Jake fouls it off to stay alive. Be Matt Heck on deck and then Grant Buck. Inside evens the count on Fulshon. Two-two pitch. Fulshon takes it outside. It's a full count on Jake. Payoff pitch on the way. That's driven into left center field. That's down for a base hit. Fulshon makes a turnaround first, heading for second. The throw is in time, and Fulshon is out.
Right fielder number 5, Matt Heck.
So here's Matt Heck, senior right fielder from Midlothian. Takes a strike on the outside corner. Matt went 2-for-4 with an RBI and a run scored. The first game, one of those hits was a double. Fouls this one off. Down the count 0-2. Heck now hitting 262. A double, a triple, a home run, 5 RBIs, and 7 runs scored. O2 pitch from Hatcher. Tries to put a slider on the inside corner, and Heck fouls it off. A ground ball towards short. Morales backhands it. The throw over to first is high and just clips Heck at first base. It's the second play that Morales has made like that.
Designated hitter number 15, Greg Buck.
Got Halloran to end the first inning on a very similar play. Tier just able to stay on the bag in both cases. So here's Grant Buck, junior designated hitter today from Carlsbad, California. First pitch swinging, comes up empty. Grant 1-for-2, walked and scored a run in the first game. Now hitting 233, two RBIs and a run scored. Swings and misses at that one, behind in the count 0-2. Grant ripped the pitch in his one hit in the first game. Right off the wall, ricocheted right to the right fielder, held him to a long single. Here's the 0-2, a breaking ball, swung on and missed by Buck. And we go to the third inning. Nicholls 2, HBU nothing here on the Husky Sports Network.
I'm Alan Helfman, and I'm president of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram. And I'm here at Tony's in the Kitchen with Chef Kate and Tony Vallone.
Waitress Provost at Tony's serving my friend Nick.
Thank you. Love my pasta. Love my Jeep. From Alan Helfman at River Oaks Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram.
Ci vediamo. Come see us at River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram. Kirby, the Southwest Freeway.
It's our drive and discovery event.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
Top of the third inning in Houston.
Off the third for the Colonels, the
Nicholls with a 2-0 lead over HBU. Back to the top of the order for the Colonels and Ethan Valdez. Valdez grounded out to short to lead off the game. Junior second baseman from San Antonio and Brennan High School. Takes the ball upstairs. Batting with a 1-0 pitch. That's up and in. Popped up into shallow left field. Halloran waiting there. Spencer makes a catch for the first out.
Shortstop.
We'll take a look at the Southland Conference scoreboard this inning. McNeese leading Stephen F. Austin 6-3, bottom of the sixth inning in Nacogdoches. Batten's first pitch to Morales is popped up into shallow center. Tyler DePreta Johnson's there. Makes the catch for the second out. The one non-conference series going on this weekend, Northwestern State trailing Nebraska 2-0 top of the third inning.
Fielder number 5, Chet Niehaus.
Abilene Christian leading New Orleans 1-0 top of the third inning in Abilene. Southeastern Louisiana leading Lamar 4-1 top of the third in Beaumont. Just about to get underway, Incarnate Word is at Central Arkansas. Here's Niehaus. Chet Niehaus takes a strike. Grounded into a 6-4-3 double play to end the first inning. At 4 o'clock, Sam Houston State is at Texas A&M Corpus Christi. And then later on tonight, the second game of a doubleheader between Incarnate Word and UCA. Niehaus takes a slider outside, and it's 1-1. Pitch misses high, 2 balls and a strike. Two-one from Batten. Niehaus takes high, 3 balls and a strike. Three and one, 2 outs, bases empty. Pitch on the way to Niehaus, popped up on the infield. Riley, the second baseman, taking charge, makes the catch for the third out. We go to the bottom of the third inning, Nicholls 2, HBU nothing, here on the Husky Sports Network.
How can I help you?
Have you ever walked into the paint store feeling like you should really know more than you know? Satin versus semi-gloss and I don't know.
Yes, I know the feeling.
That's how I feel right now about all of the financing options for this project I'm doing. I feel like I should know more than I know.
Don't sweat it. We have this new tool, My Credit Options Guide, that gives you a customized comparison like this, which helps you discover which credit options might be right for you.
Oh, this is better. They should make one for paint.
Want to get started?
Sure.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
Kerry Jones will lead it off for HBU here in the bottom of the third inning. Be followed by Tyler DePreta Johnson and Elijah Simone. Kerry, senior first baseman from Cypress, Texas and Cy Ranch High School. Kerry went 2-for-5 with a double. Drove in a run, scored 3 times in the first game. Kerry, 4-for-27 on the year. Pair of doubles, 2 RBIs, 5 runs scored. Slider for a strike to Jones on the inside corner. Another breaking ball for a strike, this time on the outside edge. Hatcher has done a good job of getting ahead in the count. Several 0-2 counts here at the beginning. That 0-2 fastball misses outside. Jones with a swing and a miss. Second strikeout of the game for Hatcher.
Shortstop number three, Tyler DePreda Johnson.
Here's Tyler DePreda Johnson, senior shortstop from Rancho Santa Margarita, California. Went 1-for-3 with a home run, a pair of RBIs, a pair of runs scored in game one. Now up to 208. Pair of doubles, three home runs, 12 RBIs, 8 runs scored. Takes that pitch outside for a ball. Low and away, and it's 2-0. Swinging a foul back, 2-1. One out, nobody on, bottom of the third. Nicholls leading HBU 2-0. Two-one pitch. That misses inside. Hatcher winds and delivers. That is outside for ball four. Only the second walk issued by Hatcher. Now in his 26th inning of work this year. He's got 25 strikeouts with the two he has today compared to two walks on the year. So here's Elijah Simone, sophomore third baseman from Angleton, Brazosport Christian High School. Strike on the outside corner to Simone. Eli went 1-for-3 with a double, two RBIs, two runs scored in the first game. Came in and pinch hit for Anthony Jones. Anthony had some troubles in left field, making two errors. It led to a pair of runs in what at the time was a close game. So, Simone getting the start at third, Halloran in left here in game two. The 0-1 pitch, that misses down low. Said Simone didn't check his swing, didn't look like he went around that far, but it is 0-2. O2 pitch. Simone fouls it back. Throw over to first and DePreda Johnson just back in. Another throw over. This one skips in front of Tier. He has to block it. Simone fouls that one off. So Eli is staying alive. 0-2 count, one out, runner on at first. Hatcher comes set the 0-2 pitch, and that one driven the other way for another foul ball. So Simone digs back in. DePreta Johnson leads away from first. Pitch from Hatcher. Up and away for a ball. Hatcher still trying to hold DePreta Johnson close over at first. Here's the 1-2. Simone swings and misses and strikes out. Three strikeouts now for Hatcher. Back to the top of the order and Jonathan Dukoff. Jonathan flied out to center his first time up. Jonathan with three hits yesterday in the opener. 1-for-5 in game one. Takes a breaking ball for a strike. So Nicholls won that first game yesterday 5-4 in 11 innings. Huskies even the series with a 13-4 victory here in the first game of this doubleheader. The 0-1 pitch. Dukoff with a ground ball back up the middle. DePreta Johnson is going to round second. And now it gets away from the center fielder. DePreta Johnson's going to go to third. So a single for Dukoff and an error on the center fielder allows DePreta Johnson to go to third base.
Second baseman number 9, Derek Riley.
Runners on the corners for Derek Riley. Derek flied out to center his first time up. Had a pair of hits in game one. Also walked once and drove in a pair. Fastball swung on, lifted into center. Niehaus going back. And he makes a catch for the third out. So we go to the fourth inning. Nicholls 2, HBU nothing. Here on the Husky Sports Network.
We all have special moments in life. Moments that we will remember forever. Best friends become family. At River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, we love family. You are a part of the River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram family. Live your best moments of life in a Jeep from River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram.
Don't you worry, my child. Everything's going to be just fine. Little darling, you keep on walking. Cause I ain't never going to leave your side.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe. So you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
Russ Renaud back here at Husky Field. HBU trailing Nicholls 2-0 as we go to the top of the fourth inning. Kyle Knoth to lead it off for the Colonels. Knopf doubled to lead off the second inning. Came around to score.
Leading off for Nicholls.
The first of two unearned runs for the Colonels. Knopf reached on the double. Tier walked behind that. Swing the first pitch and a pop-up. Kerry Jones right on the right field line. And he will make the catch for the out. Stayed fair, so pop-up to the first baseman.
First baseman number 10, Gage Tier.
So in that second inning, Knopf with a double, Tier with a walk. And then Simon laid down a sacrifice bunt but reached on an error. That allowed Knopf to score. Then after that, it was a pop-up and a sacrifice fly. That should have been out of the inning. But the Colonels scored a pair and lead it 2-0. So here is Tier, takes a strike from Batten. Drive into shallow center field. Dukoff can't get there. Falls in for a base hit.
Right fielder, number 27.
Now here's Dane Simon. Credited with a sacrifice, reaching on an error in that second inning. It's up here with one on and one out. Squares to bunt again, pulls it back, takes ball one. A 1-0 pitch. Ground ball back to Batten. Picks it up, throws it to short for one. Over to first, and it's not in time. So it was a comebacker to Batten. Knocked it down. Couldn't glove it. Had to pick it up. Made sure to get the out at second base to Tyler DePreta Johnson. It still made it pretty close over at first. So two outs and a runner on at first for Lee Clark. Clark popped up to second in the second inning. Ball taken down low. Runner hung up off at first but gets back. Simon, the runner at first, frustrated that he didn't take off when he saw the ball get away. Fly ball to left. Halloran came in, now drifting back, makes the catch, and we go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Nicholls 2, HBU nothing. Here on the Husky Sports Network.
That moment you realized he really does love you. That moment your boss thanked you for crushing it like a boss in the sales meeting. That moment you decided to treat you. Whatever that moment is, Tiff's Treats warm cookies, baked from scratch and delivered warm, are the perfect companion. Tiff's Treats. Order now at cookiedelivery.com.
The Southland Conference.
4,200 student athletes
from across the country
and around the world,
representing 13 member institutions
from Arkansas, Texas, and Louisiana.
Excelling in 17 NCAA Division I sports.
In the classroom.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Sweetheart, be Spencer Halloran to lead it off for the Huskies in the bottom of the fourth inning against Caden Hatcher. Hatcher, no runs, two hits, and has walked a batter through three. Halloran grounded out to short his first time up. That ended the first inning. Pitch misses inside, and it's 1-0. Slider for a strike over the inside edge. 1-1 the count. That one misses down and in. Trying to come back with that same pitch. Been working the slider on both corners pretty effectively up to this point. Two-one pitch drilled to left field, and that ball is gone. Third home run of the day for Spencer Halloran. First of this game, a solo shot makes it 2-1 Nicholls. And that ball got out in a hurry. Right in front of the HBU baseball alumni tent. It's out in left center field. Now it brings up Jake Pulshon. Pops it up on the first pitch. Bell moving over into foul territory. The third baseman puts it away for the first out. Pulshon had singled to lead off the second inning. Tried to stretch it into a double and was thrown out at second. Here's Matt Heck. Matt grounded out to short his first time up back in the second inning. Pitch gets by the catcher. 1-0. X swings and fouls it off. 1-1. 50 pitches now for Hatcher. 34 have been for strikes. 1-1 to Heck. One out, nobody on. Bottom of the fourth, 2-1 Nicholls. Heck with a ground ball to second. Taken by Valdez, the throw to first for the second out.
Designated hitter number 15, Grant Buck.
That'll bring up Grant Buck. Struck out his first time up. Saw three straight breaking balls. Swung over the top of all three. Swing and a miss here. It's 0-1. Swings and misses. It's 0-2. Hatcher deals, and that's down low for a ball. Hatcher with the 1-2 pitch. And that's taken outside to even the count. 2-2 to Buck. Base is empty with two outs. Now Hatcher with the 2-2 pitch down low, and the count goes full. Spencer Halloran with a solo home run, his fourth of the season, third in this series. He's made it a 2-1 game. Put the Huskies on the board. Payoff pitch on the way to Buck, popped up. Third baseman Bell in fair territory makes the catch for the third out. Go to the fifth inning, Nicholls 2, HBU 1, here on the Husky Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Alan Helfman, and I'm president of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram. And I'm here at Tony's in the kitchen with Chef Kate and Tony Vallone.
Waitress Provost at Tony's serving my friend Nick.
Thank you. Love my pasta. Love my Jeep. From Alan Helfman at River Oaks Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram.
Ci vediamo. Come see us at River Oaks Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram. Kirby, the Southwest Freeway.
It's our drive and discovery event.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
Landon Powell will lead it off for the Colonels here in the top of the fifth inning. Takes a strike from Brady Batten. Now the 0-1. This is down low. 50 pitches for Brady. 29 have been for strikes. Fouls it back. One ball and two strikes. Powell with a sack fly in the second inning for the Colonel's second run, but he strikes out here. First strikeout of the game for Batten.
Third baseman, number 12, Brady Bell.
There we go, Brady Bell, grounded out to short to end the second inning. Fly ball into left center field. Halloran can't get there. It's going to go to the wall. Bell into second. Makes a big turn around second and holds up there with a double. So Bell reclaims the team lead with his seventh double of the year for the Colonels. Kyle Noss double back in the second. Tied Bell momentarily. Now back to the top of the order and Ethan Valdez. Valdez 0-for-2, grounded out to short in the first inning, flied out to left in the third. Pitch up and in, 1-0. Oh. The slider for a strike on the outside corner, 1-1 to Bell. Fouled back, 1-2. Batten sets, checks the runner, now the pitch. Valdez able to lay off, and that'll even the count of 2-2. Bell at second. Now the 2-2 pitch, in there for strike three. Second strikeout of the inning for Batten, this one looking. And here's Joey Morales with two outs.
11, Joey Morales.
Runner still at second base. Nicholls leading HBU 2-1. Top of the fifth inning here at Husky Field. Series finale. Winner of this game clinches the series. Pitch is down low for 1 to Morales. Joey 1-2, singled in the first inning. Popped up to short in the third. Down and in, Pulshon able to block that one. It's 2-0. Two-0 pitch from Batten on the inside corner for a strike. I don't know if Batten missed a pickoff play at second base. DePreta Johnson was rushing over there. Everybody in the Nicholls dugout yelling back. And Batten delivered the pitch anyway, leaving a wide open hole on the left side. Here's a 2-1. Slider for a strike on the outside corner. Two-two pitch. Morales fouls it out of play on the left side. Two runs, four hits, one error for Nicholls. One run, three hits, one error for HBU. Another 2-2 on the way. Foul towards the Colonel's dugout on the first base side. Batten delivers. That one's up high and the count goes full. Payoff pitch on the way, swing and a miss. Batten strikes out the side, and we go to the bottom of the fifth inning. Nicholls 2, HBU 1, here on the Husky Sports Network.
How can I help you?
Have you ever walked into the paint store feeling like you should really know more than you know? Satin versus semi-gloss and I don't know.
Yes, I know the feeling.
That's how I feel right now about all of the financing options for this project I'm doing. I feel like I should know more than I know.
Don't sweat it. We have this new tool, My Credit Options Guide. It gives you a customized comparison like this, which helps you discover which credit options might be right for you.
Oh, this is better. They should make one for paint.
Want to get started?
Sure.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
For your Huskies, the first baseman, number 38, Kerry Jones.
There's Kerry Jones to lead it off for HBU. If we go to the bottom of the fifth inning, Huskies trailing by a run, 2-1. Kerry struck out his first time up. That led off the third inning. Sees a slider for a strike on the inside corner. Swing and a miss. Jones quickly down in the count 0-2. After with the 0-2 pitch, Jones gets a piece of it, stays alive. Another 1-2. Actually, that is ball one. One-two pitch. Jones fouls it back. Hatcher delivers. That one's fouled off the right side. Fly ball into right center field. Niehaus coming in and makes the catch for the first out. Here's Tyler DePreta Johnson.
Shortstop number 3, Tyler DePreta Johnson.
Walked his first time up. Homered in each of the first two games of this series. His two-run shot yesterday in the bottom of the 11th inning cut Nicholls' lead to 5-4. Huskies threatened to tie the game. Couldn't get that extra run across. That pitch is at on the outside corner for strike one. Anthony Jones doubled after that, put the tying run on base. 1-1-2 to DePreta Johnson. It's a two-run shot yesterday, two-run shot in game one. Down and in, two balls and a strike. 2-1 pitch. That one's fouled back to even the count. DePreta Johnson had been one for his last 15 coming into the series. Three hits yesterday. One of those a home run. And a home run today. 2-2 pitch from Hatcher. Flied into left center field. Niehaus takes charge and makes the catch for the second out. That brings up Elijah Simone.
Third baseman number 36, Elijah Simone.
Eli struck out his first time up back in the third inning. Breaking ball misses away. Fastball, that's also low and away, 2-0. A pitch on the way, drilled into left field, but it's right at Clark. Line drive out to end the inning. We go to the sixth inning. Nicholls 2, HBU 1 here on the Husky Sports Network.
How can I help you?
Have you ever walked into the paint store feeling like you should really know more than you know? Satin versus semi-gloss and I don't know.
Yes, I know the feeling.
That's how I feel right now about all of the financing options for this project I'm doing. I feel like I should know more than I know.
Don't sweat it. We have this new tool, My Credit Options Guide, that gives you a customized comparison like this, which helps you discover which credit options might be right for you.
Oh, this is better. They should make one for paint.
Want to get started?
Sure.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
Russ Renault welcoming you back to Husky Field. Rain has held off so far on this Saturday. We play this doubleheader. Rain's not supposed to hold off tomorrow. That's why we're playing two today. Trying to get this series in. Nicholls leading it 2-1 as we go to the top of the sixth inning. It'll be Chet Niehaus to lead it off against Brady Batten. Niehaus 0-2, grounded into a double play to end the first. Popped up to second to end the third. Tries to bunt his way on, and it rolls foul. Niehaus, a senior from Hammond, has had quite a series here for the Colonels. Two RBIs in the first game of the doubleheader. Home run, three RBIs yesterday's first game. Batten with the 0-1. Off-speed pitch misses high. Niehaus fouls it off. Count remains 1-2. On, Nicholls staying alive. 70th pitch now for Batten. 43 for strikes. That's in on the fifth, fouled off by Nicholls. Frustrated that he didn't either let that one hit him or that he could take it for ball two. But instead, got a piece of the bat, and it's 1-2. Nobody out, nobody on. Get to the Southland Conference scoreboard this half inning. McNeese leading Stephen F. Austin 11-3 in the bottom of the seventh inning in Nacogdoches. Nicholls, defensive swing, fights that one off. Nebraska leading Northwestern State 2-0, bottom of the fourth inning in Lincoln. Abilene Christian leading New Orleans 3-2, bottom of the fifth inning in Abilene. That pitch just misses a little low. Looked like a pretty good pitch on the knees. So now it's 2-2. That's in there for... That one was right on the inside corner. Called a ball. That is two pitches that were very good pitches from Brady Batten. The payoff pitch. That one is called low. Those were three great pitches. And Nicholls draws a walk. It's a leadoff walk for the Colonels center fielder.
Catcher number 18, Kyle Noth.
That brings up Kyle Noth, who doubled and scored in the second inning. Led off that inning. Back to the Southland Conference scoreboard, Southeastern Louisiana leading Lamar 6-1, bottom of the sixth inning in Beaumont. Huskies will take on Southeastern Louisiana next weekend in Hammond. Pitch misses outside, 1-0. Friday, Saturday, Sunday in Hammond, Louisiana next weekend. Central Arkansas leading Incarnate Word 2-0, bottom of the first inning, first game of a doubleheader between the Cardinals and the Bears. Pitch is driven into center field. It's going to be down for a base hit. Nicholls going to third. Throw comes in to second. Runners on the corners with nobody out for the Colonels here in the top of the sixth inning. One other game about to get started in about 15 minutes. Sam Houston State at Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Here's Gage Tier. 1-for-1, walked and scored in the second. Singled in the fourth. Strike one to Tier. Batten steps off. The strike on the outside corner, batting ahead in the count 0-2. 0-2 pitch from Batten. Swung on and fouled off. Tier digs back in. Noth away from first. Niehaus, the runner at third. Another 0-2 pitch. This one flied into right field. Matt Heck coming in underneath it. Throw comes in, and it is wide. So Niehaus scores, and the Colonels lead it 3-1. Sack fly for Tier. Noth stays at first.
Right fielder number 27, Dane Simon.
So now it's Dane Simon. 0-1. Reached on an error, but was credited with a sacrifice in the second inning. And reached on a fielder's choice in the fourth. Fastball misses low, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch, runner goes, the throw down to second. Give me interference on the batter. The runner will have to go back to first as Simon came across home plate, interfered with Pulshawn's throw. It's called the strike, is swing and a miss. Nicholls head coach Seth Thibodeau going out to talk to home plate umpire Jerry Johnson. The batter's out. So there's two outs on the interference call.
Left fielder number 4.
So Noth back to first, and Simon is out on the interference. So now here's Lee Clark. Clark 0-2, popped up to second in the second inning, flied out to left to end the fourth. Comes up with Noth at first and two down. Off-speed pitch misses away, 1-0. Pitch. Clark drills it to right, but it's well fouled. The 1-1 pitch, up and in. Two on from Batten. That misses high. Three one. Now line drive into center and a base hit.
Designated hitter number 17, Landon Powell.
Now the batter's Landon Powell. 0 for 1. Sack fly in the second inning. And struck out to lead off the fifth. Ground ball to first. Kerry Jones has it. Takes it himself to the bag for the third out. Colonels leave a pair on, and we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. Nicholls 3, HBU 1 here on the Husky Sports Network.
We all have special moments in life. Moments that we will remember forever. Best friends become family. At River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, we love family. You are a part of the River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram family. Live your best moments of life in a Jeep from River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram.
Don't you worry, my child. Everything's going to be just fine. Little darling, you keep on walking. Because I ain't never going to leave your side.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe, so you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
Bottom of the sixth inning in Houston. Be Jonathan Dukoff to lead it off for the Huskies against Caden Hatcher. Be followed by Derek Riley and Spencer Halloran. So top of the order due up for the Huskies. Dukoff 1 for 2 in this second game of the doubleheader. Flied out to center in the first inning, singled in the third.
27, Jonathan Dukoff.
First pitch on the way from Hatcher. It's called strike on the inside corner. Popped up on the infield. Morales calls for it at shortstop. Makes the catch for the first out.
Second baseman, number 9, Derek Riley.
Here's Derek Riley. 0 for 2, flied out to center both times, once in the first and again in the third. Fastball down and in to Riley. Ground ball towards third. Bell has it. The throw to first for the second out.
Left fielder number 14, Spencer Halloran.
Two outs and nobody on for Spencer Halloran. Pitch looked down and in, but called a strike. Halloran's 1 for 2, grounded out to short in the first inning. Solo home run to lead off the fourth. And slider for a strike on the inside corner. the 0-2 pitch. Spencer gets a piece of it. The drive into left, sending Clark back, but he makes the catch for the third out. A 1-2-3 inning for the Colonels, and we go to the seventh inning. Nicholls 3, HBU 1, here on the Husky Sports Network.
That moment you realized he really does love you. That moment your boss thanked you for crushing it like a boss in the sales meeting. That moment you decided to treat you. Whatever that moment is, Tiff's Treats warm cookies, baked from scratch and delivered warm, are the perfect companion. Tiff's Treats. Order now at cookiedelivery.com.
The Southland Conference.
4,200 student athletes
from across the country
and around the world, representing 13 member institutions
from Arkansas,
Texas, and Louisiana.
Excelling in 17 NCAA Division I sports.
In the classroom.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Russell Noe back here at Husky Field as we go to the top of the seventh inning. Brady Batten to face Brady Bell. Then back to the top of the order with Ethan Valdez and Joey Morales for Nicholls.
Leading off the seventh for the Colonels, third baseman number 12, Brady Bell.
Bell 1-for-2 today, grounded out to short in the second inning and doubled in the fifth. Swings at the first pitch and a fly ball into center, right at Dukaw. Puts it away for the first out. 90 pitches now for Batten. Done 55 for strikes. There's action in the Huskies' bullpen.
Second baseman number 3, Ethan Valdez.
Here's Valdez, shows bunt, takes a strike on the outside corner. Here's Weston Smart, warming up in the Huskies' bullpen. It's kind of hard to tell, everybody looks the same now. Everybody got their heads shaved yesterday. Supporting Versus Cancer, Children's Brain Tumor Foundation. It's a foundation that took the entrance of Jonathan Dukoff, Husky center fielder. There's a ball taken inside. Jonathan battling follicular lymphoma. Seeing the many children over at MD Anderson during his treatment who are affected by cancer. Jonathan wanted to use his status as a college athlete to make a difference. There's a foul ball back by Valdez, and it's 2-2. So the Huskies have supported Versus Cancer, and yesterday raised money by shaving their head, so everybody out there bald now. Pitch is fouled off. So 2-2 the count on Valdez. Batten winds and deals. Now ground ball back to the pitcher. Batten walks it over to Jones, underhands it for the second out. I bring up Joey Morales.
Shortstop number 11, Joey Morales.
1-for-3, singled in the first inning, popped up to short in the third, struck out to end the fifth. Batten misses high, and it's 1-0. Fastball down, two balls, no strikes. The bat misses down low with a third straight pitch. Fastball, four strike. 100th pitch of the game for Batten, has thrown 60 for strikes. One pitch misses just low and outside. Morales draws a two-out walk.
Center fielder number five, Chet Niehaus.
I bring up Chet Niehaus. It's 0 for 2, grounded into a double play in the first inning. Popped up to second to end the third as he takes a strike from Batten. Led off the sixth inning with a walk and came around to score. That made it 3-1. Runner goes, pitches a strike, the throw down to second. DePreta Johnson can't handle it. Pitcher's actually called a ball. It's a stolen base for Morales. Third stolen base of the year for the Cardinals shortstop. 1-1 the count on Niehaus. The 1-1 from Batten. That hits the inside corner. 1-2. Batten looks in. Now comes Seth. Check of the runner at second and the 1-2. Niehaus with a ground ball to first. Kerry Jones has it. Steps on the bag for the third out. Go to the seventh inning stretch. Nicholls 3, HBU 1. Right, here on the Husky Sports Network.
Stand up and get loose.
Hi, I'm Alan Helfman, and I'm president of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram. And I'm here at Tony's in the kitchen with Chef Kate and Tony Vallone.
Waitress Provost at Tony's serving my friend Nick.
Thank you. Love my pasta. Love my Jeep. From Alan Helfman at River Oaks Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram.
Ci vediamo. Come see us at River Oaks Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram. Kirby, the Southwest Freeway.
It's our drive and discovery event.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
Russ Renaud back here at Husky Field. HBU trailing Nicholls 3-1 here in the series finale of the Southland Conference Series. Caden Hatcher back out there for the Colonels. They'll face Jake Fulshawn, Matt Heck, and Grant Buck here in the bottom of the seventh. Jake 1-for-2 today, singled in the second inning. Fouled out to the third baseman in the fourth.
Take it off for your Huskies, the catcher, number 40, Jake Fulshawn.
First pitch from Hatcher in there for a strike. Huskies with only one run on three hits. Nicholls with three runs on six hits, each team with an error. Pitch is low and away, 1-1. Breaking ball for a strike on the outer edge. Hatcher's 1-2 pitch. Fulshawn fouls it off. Another 1-2. Jake lifts one into left field. Niehaus in left center makes the catch for the first out.
Right fielder, number 5, Matt Heck.
So here's Matt Heck, 0-for-2, grounded out to short in the second inning, grounded out to second in the fourth. Takes a ball from Hatcher. Ground ball to short. Morales comes up with it. Spin and a throw to first for the second out. Brings up Grant Buck.
Hitter number 15,
0-for-2, struck out in the second inning. Popped up to third, two in the fourth. Strike one to Buck on the off-speed pitch on the inside corner. Hatcher misses away, 1-1. Buck swings and misses. Behind in the count now, 1-2. 90 pitches for Hatcher. 62 have been for strikes. One-two pitch, low and outside. Two-two from Hatcher. Buck with a chopper the other way, Bell charging in. Makes the off-balance throw in time for the out. Go to the eighth inning, Nicholls 3, HBU 1. Here on the Husky Sports Network.
Husky fans, guys.
How can I help you?
Have you ever walked into the paint store feeling like you should really know more than you know? Satin versus semi-gloss and I don't know.
Yes, I know the feeling.
That's how I feel right now about all of the financing options for this project I'm doing. I feel like I should know more than I know.
Don't sweat it. We have this new tool, My Credit Options Guide. It gives you a customized comparison like this, which helps you discover which credit options might be right for you.
Oh, this is better. They should make one for paint.
Want to get started?
Sure.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
Go to the eighth inning, HBU trailing Nicholls 3-1 here in this Southland Conference Series finale. New pitcher on the mound for the Huskies, senior right-hander Weston Smart. 6'1", 185 pounds from Hempstead, Texas, Hempstead High School, Tyler Junior College. Weston making his sixth appearance of the year. No record, 5.68 ERA. He's given up four runs on seven hits, four strikeouts, three walks, and six and a third innings. Face Kyle Knoth to lead it off here in the eighth inning for the Colonels.
Number 18, Kyle Knoth.
Knoth 2-for-3 today. Doubled and scored in the second inning. Popped up to the first baseman in the fourth and singled in the sixth. Smart misses outside, 1-0. Left-hander warming up in the Huskies' bullpen is Taylor Fransman. The ground ball to first, Kerry Jones has it, takes it himself to the bag for the first out.
First baseman, number 10, Gage Tier.
Here's Gage Tier. It's 1-for-1, officially. Walked and scored in the second inning. Singled in the fourth, and a sacrifice fly in the sixth. First pitch from Smart misses down. Ground ball up the middle. Another base hit for Tier. So he's 2-for-2 today. One out base runner for the Colonels here in the eighth inning. That'll bring up Dane Simon.
Right fielder number 27, Dane Simon.
Simon, 0-for-2. Reached on an error on a sacrifice in the second inning. Reached on a fielder's choice in the fourth, then out on batter's interference in the sixth inning when Knoth was trying to steal second. First pitch, a little bit low for a ball. Swing and a miss. 1-1 to Simon. One out and one on. Tier the runner at first. Smart delivers. Misses outside. Ground ball towards short. DePreta Johnson flips it to Riley for one. Over to first, and it's not in time. Simon just beats it out to avoid the double play.
Left fielder number 4, Lee Clark.
Now it's Lee Clark with a runner on and two outs. Clark 1-for-3, popped up to second in the second. Flied out to left in the fourth and singled in the sixth. Mm-hmm. Smart with the pitch. The runner goes, the throw down to second, and it skips into center field. Runner heading towards third. There'll be no play. So Simon going to second on a wild pitch and went to third on the error. The throw going into center field. Error's going to be on Pulshan, the catcher. Runner at third with two outs. There's a strike to Clark. Swing and a miss. Smart looks in, now comes set. The 1-2 pitch on the way. Clark right off the end of the bat for a foul ball to stay alive. Another 1-2 from Smart, and another foul ball by Clark. Smart delivers. Swing and a miss, and a strikeout to end the inning. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. Nicholls 3, HBU 1, here on the Husky Sports Network.
We all have special moments in life. Moments that we will remember forever. Best friends become family. At River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, we love family. You are a part of the River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram family. Live your best moments of life in a Jeep from River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram.
Don't you worry, my child. Everything's going to be just fine. Little darling, you keep on walking. Cause I ain't never gonna leave your side.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe. So you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
Pinch hitting and leading off for the Huskies, number one, Anthony Jones.
So I have a pinch hitter for Kerry Jones here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Be Anthony Jones to lead it off, junior outfielder from Missouri City, Ridge Point High School, Blinn College. Anthony takes a strike. Anthony went 0 for 2 in the first game of this doubleheader, hitting 250 on the year. Hatcher back out there, now the 0-1. Drilled into left, and Clark going back, and that ball is gone! A solo home run for Anthony Jones. A pinch hit home run in his first of his HBU career. That makes it 3-2 Nicholls. Anthony Jones trying to fire up his teammates as Huskies now with them one. Scored all of their runs on solo home runs today, one by Halloran in the fourth, and now Anthony Jones here in the eighth. And it brings up Tyler DePreta Johnson. Takes a ball low and outside. It's 1-0. Hatcher with the pitch. DePreta Johnson takes it down and in. 2-0. DePreta Johnson chops it to third. Bell across the diamond. The throw is low, but dug out by the first baseman, Tier, for out number one.
Third baseman number 36, Elijah Simone.
Brings up Elijah Simone. Eli 0 for 2, struck out in the third inning, flied out to left in the fifth. That's down low, 1-0. Hatcher winds and delivers. Simone, a little half swing, couldn't check it. It's 1-1. Hatcher delivers, Simone chops it foul. 100th pitch of the game for Hatcher. He's thrown 68 for strikes. Now the 1-2. Down and in to even the count. Two-two pitch. Simone pops it up. Noth has room. He will make the catch for the second out. Now here's Jonathan Dukoff.
Center fielder number 27.
It's 1-for-3. Flied out to center in the first inning. Singled in the third. Popped up to short in the sixth. Jonathan takes a strike on the inner half. 0-1. Two outs and nobody on. HBU trailing Nicholls 3-2 in the bottom of the eighth. Dukoff fouls it off. Behind in the count now, 0-2. An 0-2 pitch from Hatcher, a chopper off the end of the bat. Hatcher has it, throws it over to first for the third out. We go to the ninth inning, Nicholls 3, HBU 2, here on the Husky Sports Network.
That moment you realized he really does love you. That moment your boss thanked you for crushing it like a boss in the sales meeting. That moment you decided to treat you. Whatever that moment is, Tiff's Treats warm cookies, baked from scratch and delivered warm, are the perfect companion. Tiff's Treats. Order now at cookiedelivery.com.
The Southland Conference.
4,200 student athletes
from across the country
and around the world,
representing 13 member institutions
from Arkansas, Texas, and Louisiana.
Excelling in 17 NCAA Division I sports.
In the classroom.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong. Strong.
Go to the ninth inning. Weston Smart back out there for HBU. His second inning of relief. He'll face Landon Powell and Brady Bell and Ethan Valdez. 8-9-1 due up for the Colonels. Powell 0-for-2, a sack fly in the second. Struck out in the fifth. Grounded out the first two in the sixth. It's the first pitch from Smart. That's on the inner edge for strike one. That pitch is up and it's 1-1. Smart bounces one in front of the plate. Two balls and a strike to Powell. So your defensive changes. Jake Pulshon at first base. Now Eric Voller behind the plate. Huskies pinch hit for the starting first baseman, Kerry Jones. Anthony Jones pinch hit for him. Now Voller's in that spot. Fitch is down, and it's 3-1 to Powell. Smart with the 3-1 pitch. Fouled back for a full count. Nobody up in the Huskies' bullpen. And I'm sure that means that should Smart run into trouble, that Matt Heck would be coming in from right field. Payoff pitch to Powell. Misses low and away in a leadoff walk.
Baseman number
12. I'm going to have a pinch runner for Powell over at first. It's going to be Waylon LeBlanc, freshman from Huntville, Louisiana. So Bell 1-for-3, grounded out to short in the second inning, doubled in the fifth, flied out to center to lead off the seventh. Simone in on the grass at third. Bell squares to bunt. He offers at it, and it's strike one. Squares around to bunt again. Pops it up, and it goes straight back. Smart ahead in the count, 0-2. Smart comes set. Bell squares the bunt again, but pulls it back. The ball bounces in front of the plate. Voller blocks it. Franzman back up in the pen for HBU. Now the 1-2 pitch. Bell pops it up on the left side. Halloran coming in. Calls off to Preta Johnson and makes the catch for the first out. Back to the top of the order and Ethan Valdez. 0-for-4. Grounded out to short in the first inning. Flied out to left in the third. Struck out in the fifth. Rounded back to the pitcher in the seventh. Up with one out and one on here in the top of the ninth inning. Nicholls leading 3-2. First pitch from Smart. This is just a bit high. The 1-0, swinging a foul tip by Valdez. Smart looking into his catcher, Voller checks the runner at first. 1-1. Chopper foul towards the Huskies dugout on the third base side. One ball and two strikes. Smart sets, and now the 1-2. That's on the outside corner for strike three. Second strikeout of the game for Weston. Brings up Joey Morales now.
Shortstop number 11, Joey Morales.
It's 1-for-3, singled in the first inning, popped up to short in the third, struck out to end the fifth, then walked in the seventh. First pitch from Smart, chop foul. Three runs, seven hits, one error for Nicholls. Two runs, four hits, two errors for HBU. Colonel scored two unearned runs in the second inning. Huskies solo home run from Spencer Halloran in the fourth. Colonel's added a run in the sixth inning. Pitches down, blocked by Voller. Then Anthony Jones with the pinch hit solo home run to lead off the eighth inning has made it 3-2. We're in the ninth now with two down for the Colonels here in the top half. One pitch from Smart. Misses outside for ball two. Smart with the 2-1, up high. Ball three to Morales. Smart checks the runner at first. It's LeBlanc, pinch runner after Powell, who walked. Now the 3-1 pitch. Just missed. Must have been a little low. Now going to be Chad Niehaus. That's going to be it for Weston Smart. We'll have a new pitcher tell you all about him when we come back here on the Husky Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Alan Helfman, and I'm president of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram. And I'm here at Tony's in the kitchen with Chef Kate and Tony Vallone.
Waitress Provost at Tony's serving my friend me.
Thank you. Love my pasta. Love my Jeep. From Alan Helfman at River Oaks Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram.
Ci vediamo. Come see us at River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram. Kirby, the Southwest Freeway.
It's our drive and discovery event.
We see your compassion and your tireless dedication. We see your selflessness, and we applaud you for it. We want you to have the freedom to be uniquely, passionately, and gloriously you. At Houston Baptist University, we're creating online programs that give moms, service members, retirees, and everyone in between the freedom to be who they are and to never stop learning. Learn more at hbuonline.com.
New pitcher on the mound for the Huskies is junior left-hander Taylor Fransman. 5'10", 210 pounds from Garden Grove, California, Pacifica High School, Golden West College. Taylor making his fifth appearance. No record, 5.14 ERAs, giving up 4 runs on 6 hits, 6 strikeouts, 5 walks in 7 innings. Brought in to face a left-handed batting Chet Niehaus. Runners at first and second with 2 outs. Weston Smart walking Powell to lead off the inning. And then Morales here with 2 outs. Now it's Fransman to face the left-handed batter Niehaus. Breaking ball misses up. It's 1-0. LeBlanc is the pinch runner at second base. And Morales at first. Niehaus 0-3. Grounded into a double play in the first inning. Popped up to second in the third. Walked and scored when he let off the sixth. Then grounded out to first to end the seventh. So pitch outside. It's 2-0. A 2-0 from Fransman, and that's up high for ball three. Also a lefty on deck in Kyle Knopf. So now the 3-0. Up and in. 4-pitch walk to Niehaus. Head coach Jared Moon comes out. And now he's going to go to Matt Heck. I have another pitching change for the Huskies. We'll come back and tell you about them right after this here on the Husky Sports Network.
We all have special moments in life. Moments that we will remember forever. Best friends become family. At River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram, we love family. You are a part of the River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram family. Live your best moments of life in a Jeep from River Oaks Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe, so you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
So the new pitcher for the Huskies is senior right-hander Matt Heck. Just came in from right field. He's from Midlothian, 5'10", 180 pounds. Matt making his seventh appearance. He's 2-0 with a 4.91 ERA. He's recorded one save. Given up four runs on 11 hits, seven strikeouts, two walks, and seven in a third innings. And with Heck coming into the game to pitch, Jake Scott has come in to play right field. And now Halloran has moved to right. Jake Scott is in left. So Heck to face Kyle Noth. Here with the bases loaded and two outs in the ninth inning. And Nicholls leading by a run. A ground ball to short. DePreta Johnson flips it to Riley at second for the force out. And the Colonels leave the bases loaded. We go to the bottom of the ninth. Nicholls 3, HBU 2 here on the Husky Sports Network.
That moment you realized he really does love you. That moment your boss thanked you for crushing it like a boss in the sales meeting. That moment you decided to treat you. Whatever that moment is, Tiff's Treats warm cookies, baked from scratch and delivered warm, are the perfect companion. Tiff's Treats. Order now at cookiedelivery.com.
The Southland Conference.
4,200 student athletes
from across the country
and around the world,
representing 13 member institutions
from Arkansas, Texas, and Louisiana.
Excelling in 17 NCAA Division I sports.
In the classroom.
And in our communities.
We are Southland Strong.
Russ Renault back here at Husky Field. Caden Hatcher still in there for the Colonels, trying to go the distance with Nicholls leading HBU 3-2 as we go to the bottom of the ninth. Hatcher has thrown 105 pitches. He'll face the 2-3-4 hitters, Derek Riley, Spencer Halloran, and then Jake Pulshon.
Here for the Huskies, the second baseman, number 9, Derek Riley.
Here's Derek Riley, 0-for-3 today, flying out to center. In the first inning, then again in the third, grounded out to third in the sixth. There we go, Hatcher against Riley. Breaking ball misses up. The 1-0 pitch. Riley takes a strike on the inside corner. There's action in the Colonel's bullpen. Can't see a number. 1-1. That's in there for strike two. The 1-2 from Hatcher. Riley swings on a chopper back to the mound. Hatcher has it. The throw to first for the first out. There's Spencer Halloran. 1-for-3. Grounded out to short in the first inning. Solo home run to lead off the fourth. Then flied out to left in the sixth. Hatcher's first pitch to Halloran. Spencer takes a healthy hack and fouls it off. 110 pitches now for Hatcher. Here's the 0-1. That is inside to even the count. Now the 1-1. Halloran pops it up on the infield. Bell, the third baseman, under it. And he makes the catch for the second out. Huskies down to their final out. It's going to be pinch hitter Tyler Clark for Jake Pulshon.
Attention, please. Pinch hitting for the Huskies, number 20, Tyler Clark.
Clark, junior outfielder from Mission Viejo, California, Mission Viejo High School, Saddleback College. We have a visit out to the mound by the Colonels. Clark on the season hitting 250, 3 for 12. Home run, a couple of RBIs and 3 runs scored. His first home run of his HBU career at Louisiana Tech last weekend. So it's Clark with 2 outs and the bases empty. Huskies trailing by a run in the bottom of the 9th inning. First pitch from Hatcher and a fly ball into right field, and they got a base runner on here in the 9th inning. Bobbled in right field by Simon momentarily, but Clark can't advance. So a base runner on. Gonna have a pinch runner as Zach Carter is gonna run for Tyler Clark at first base.
Attention, please, pinch running at first base for Husky number 34, Zach Carter. Now batting for the Huskies, number 5, right fielder, Matt Heck.
Here's Matt Heck.
Pitcher, number 5, Matt Heck.
Matt Heck, now the pitcher. Started the game in right field. He's 0 for 3. Grounded out to short in the second inning. Grounded out to second in the fourth. Grounded out to short his last time up in the seventh. Drilled to left. That ball is back. It's deep. And it's a walk-off home run for Matt Heck. The Huskies win the game 4-3 and take the series on a walk-off jack. Wow. Matt Heck with 2 outs, him and Tyler Clark picking the Huskies up. Tyler Clark with a 2-out single to reach base. And then Matt Heck with a 2-run home run.
Remember, we'll be back here Tuesday at 12 noon.
Matt Heck with a 2-run blast. That is Matt's second home run of the season. RBI's number 6 and 7. I got to catch my breath. We're going to come back here on the HBU postgame show. We'll wrap this one up. You're listening to the Husky Sports Network. Russ Renault back here at Husky Field. An exciting end to this series as the Huskies sweep a doubleheader from Nicholls 13-4 in the first game. 4-3 on a walk-off two-run homer by Matt Heck. The bottom of the ninth inning, Tyler Clark with a pinch hit single with two outs, and Heck follows with a two-run homer. Check of the Southland Conference scoreboard before we get out of here, and we'll get to the final stats in just a second. Let's get down to the Southland Conference. And Huskies 13-4 winner in the first game, 4-3 here. McNeese 12-3 winner over Stephen F. Austin. Northwestern State leading Nebraska 3-2 bottom of the eighth inning in Lincoln. Abilene Christian a 6-5 winner over New Orleans, and Southeastern Louisiana defeated Lamar 8-1. It's Incarnate Word trailing Central Arkansas 8-3 bottom of the seventh inning, first game of a doubleheader between the Bears and the Cardinals. Sam Houston State with a 2-0 lead over Texas A&M Corpus Christi in the bottom of the second in Corpus. And then later on tonight, the second game of that doubleheader between UIW and UCA. So here's a look at your final total board. Huskies, 4 runs, 6 hits, 2 errors. Nicholls, 3 runs, 7 hits, 1 error. Your winning pitcher is Matt Heck, and gets the win and the walk-off home run. I guess he knew that he was the pitcher of record who could get the win. Brady Batten was on the hook for the loss up until that. Batten went 7 strong innings, gave up 3 runs. Only one of them was earned on 6 hits. 3 strikeouts, 3 walks, and 7 innings. Weston Smart, an inning and 2/3 of scoreless ball. And the loss goes to Caden Hatcher. Tough luck for him. 0-2 on the season now. Gave up 4 runs, 6 hits, 3 strikeouts, 1 walk. Went the distance for the Colonels, 8 2/3 innings. Matt Heck, the hero of the day, a 2-run home run. Spencer Halloran with a solo shot. Anthony Jones with a solo shot. So all 4 of the Huskies' runs coming via the long ball. Kyle Knoth went 2-for-5 for the Colonels and scored a run. Gage Tier, 2-for-2 with an RBI and a run score. So that is going to wrap it up for us here on the HBU Baseball post-game show. Hope you enjoyed the series, and we hope that you join us here at home on Tuesday when the Huskies take on Texas Southern. That's a noon start, so there had been 3 o'clock posted earlier, but that is noon on Tuesday right here at Husky Field. We'll have that for you right here on the Husky Sports Network, and then we'll head to Hammond next weekend for a Southland Conference series against Southeastern Louisiana. We'll have those for you on the Legacy Sports Network, audio only. So join us here on the Husky Sports Network. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, everybody. As the Huskies sweep the doubleheader, we'll see you next time. This is Russ Renault saying goodbye.
You've been listening to HBU Husky Sports on the Husky Sports Network, powered by the Legacy Sports Network. These broadcasts are brought to you by the corporate sponsors of HBU Athletics, including Houston Federal Credit Union, the Memorial Hermann Healthcare System, Pepsi, GEICO, Raising Cane's, Kolache Factory, and IBEW Local 716. That's going to wrap it up for now.